Didn't I say quit playing?
What's up? Oh my God, my eyebrows is on fleek, okay? And I was rushing doing them. Anyway, what's up, y'all? I really need to get myself together. It is 101. And I was like, let me do a video really quick. I have been consistent shooting content, but I have not been consistent posting content. I have hours and hours of content on my phone and on my tablet and all of the things. So I'm trying to figure out how I'm going to do this. I know I need to do like a where I've been kind of intro situation. And I'm not even sure where I'm even going to put this video now that I think about it. But I wanted to chop it up when I just got home from the concert. Honey, I went to Al Green. Okay, first of all, I'm getting up a little bit. What am I at? Okay. I am getting ahead of myself. So anyway, it is the day after Thanksgiving. I am in Detroit, of course, honey. You know, all I do is work and come home. And so, since I've been here, which I've taken some footage, I went to a party with my ride or dies and had an amazing time and went to a couple people houses for Thanksgiving. And so today is Friday, even though today feels like Sunday. Today is Friday, and me and my girlfriend went to go see Al Green. And baby, if he in your city, let me tell you, you need to go see him. Al still got it. Now, the show wasn't nothing but an hour. So, I'm mad I spent $100 on a show that was gonna be an hour. But like I said, I mean, he still got it. He sounds amazing. So, at any event, I am exhausted. Oh, excuse me. We went... Excuse me. We went to the, me and my sister went to the Glamaholic pop-up at 12 o'clock tomorrow. So I did that. Honey, I was too geeked to get my free beanie, okay? And my sister ended up getting multiple ones because she placed multiple orders. So now I got two beanies, honey. You can't tell me nothing. But yeah, so I think for me, the biggest thing when it comes down to like my social media, I'm a private person and I'm still trying to find the line of like what I share and what I don't. Because like, I'm not the kind of person to have like a close friends on Instagram. Like, you either know or you don't know. I mean, honestly. So, I have definitely been I have been very vocal about my breast cancer journey. But not specifics, like, I'm just trying to figure this out. And my girlfriend was telling me, like, art is still art, even if, like, whether the art it costs $1 or if it's free or whether the art is $1 million, art is still art. And you are still an artist even when you go away from your art. So I found a video, and I've actually been trying to do YouTube since 2014. So I'm proud of myself that I have at least posted one video, excuse me, this year, which it just dawned on me. It's been 6 months, which is so crazy. But I'm trying to find the line of what to share and what not to share, because I mean, I'm an open book to the people that like know me and care, like I care about or care about me. But when it comes down to like random people, I'm like, no, I'm not finna tell you my business. Okay. So that's the thing. But I also know that I have a voice, and I also know that I have a mission, and my mission in life. First of all, get into my earrings. They are let me see. Can you see them? They are rhinestone seats, honey. So, baby, when I wear these, that means sit your down. Okay. But anyway, I know I have a mission. And I know that in life I have, like, a purpose and a mission. And I got to figure that part out. I mean, you know, they say you are, like, always trying to figure that part out. But I don't know. I'm just rambling. I mean, you know, it is what it is. And that's another thing. Getting comfortable with talking to yourself is hilarious too. So, but I will be checking back in. Like I said, I'm trying to figure out how I'm going to put this, because I have so much footage on my phone, and I really just want to crack on some videos while I'm in Detroit, because while everybody is at work, all my family and friends are at work, I am going to be editing videos and figuring this out. So I mean, you know, I may not have a million subscribers, but I have a voice and I want to use it. So it is what it is. So I will see y'all tomorrow. And that's the crazy part. It's like I'm looking at the viewfinder, looking over here, looking at the viewfinder, looking at here. You just gotta learn your stuff, honey. But I'm obsessed with these earrings. When I say obsessed. Okay. Obsessed. And my eyebrows is on fleek. I need y'all to understand, honey. Fleek. I'll see y'all tomorrow. Thank you.
These will be so cute.
They got these at your Target, pick them up. They are fire. I just picked up a couple of items. Of course, my coats, my glamaholic coats. So yeah, I'm about to get ready and pack up my car and figure what I'm about to do, so.
Yeah, I like that. But I wish I could buy it. Until the end of the year.
Mm-hmm.
That's all I'm saying.
I forgot you said
it's
the
wrong, baby. So I
asked. You asked me was the acrylic actually, and I told you no.
I said you like them long like this, or no?
I mean, I really don't.
You. I need you to find a mirror right now and tell yourself it's all on me. It's all on me. This one is all on me. When I go get this degree, ultimately, I gotta go get this degree. When I go get this certification, ultimately, I got to get this certification.
I have been sick the last, I went to Detroit, and I have been sick probably maybe almost 2 weeks. I got home, had an appointment, lay down, and then I just start having the ickies. So I'm thankful I'm starting to finally feel better. and I went to Sam's, grabbed a couple items. So I'm just trying to get it together. It's about to be, of course, the Christmas holiday, and I have a ton of things I'm trying to do before the end of the year. So yeah, so grabbed a couple things, like I said, from Sam's. Picked these up. I had these over a friend of mine's house, and I loved them. So picked these up from Sam's. So they're not too bad on calorie content. I picked up these. You get 20 packs of 6. So yeah, love peanut butter, love obsessed with these. So like I said, I'm trying to pick things that are like healthy as it pertains to like not really bad as far as calories. So got that. And then I just started a new job and they sent me a welcome to the team box. I thought that was really, really cute. Then stopped at CVS, dog food for the dogs, Target run. So I had already purchased a Stanley. This is my first Stanley I've ever purchased. You know, I'm a cup girl. I said I wasn't gonna fall victim to buying another cup, and then I did. So of course these are limited edition for Christmas, so I already bought it, but I hadn't used it, and they had a coupon. Well, it was a deal where if you buy a 40-ounce Stanley quencher, you get a $5 gift card. Since I had already bought it, I just returned it and then rebought it, so I got my little $5 gift card. So, but of course you already know I'm coming pink every single time, so redid that. And then I picked these up from Target because they were on clearance, and believe it or not, they're not online anymore, because I wanted to see if they had a smaller size. I think these are too big, but I'm gonna try them, and they're like cargo faux leather, so I'm gonna try those. And then pick these up. White chip macadamia nut, and so these are pretty good. I normally get these from the QT gas station in St. Louis. Okay, bought these for an upcoming self-care trip that I'm going to, so these were $10. I just want to be able to have something like to set the mood, so these are really cool. Love these. So I got two of these. These are the nacho cheese taco shells. Really, really good. Pop them in the microwave for like 10 seconds or the oven, and then put the meat and filling in it. Bomb. So I got two of those and one of these spicy nacho. I'm sorry, spicy jalapeno. And then brown rice. I think I'm gonna make some rice just with some meat. I'm just trying to, towards the end of the year, just eat very light. I don't wanna like eat a lot of just stuff. So got this. Then I picked up this shirt. I thought it was really cute. The clearance was a mess, honey, but I managed to find this. I thought it was cute. Of course, you already know about it because it has pink in it, but Minnie Mouse. And then of course, Minnie Mouse on the back. So I thought that was cute. And I paid $9 for it. It was $20, so I thought that was cute. And then just a couple things from the Dollar Tree. So my dogs are so freaking lazy. A lot of times they do not wanna come downstairs to eat when we are all upstairs. So I bought this so I can put dog food upstairs in it. Oh my God, the craziest thing. So that, and then these breast cancer cups. So I'm gonna start doing like little gift bags for women who have breast cancer. So I bought this as like a part of the bag. Got those from Dollar Tree. And then some hooks that I need for upstairs. And some wallabies. The blueberry, my homegirl loved these, the blueberry pomegranate. So bought these because I wanted to try it. So I'm gonna put everything up and I'll be back. What's the weather?
that's cute. Hey, this is so cute. I think I want these. See if they have them in my size. I don't see. It's a 9, 9.5. Maybe I'll try the 9.5.
What's happening?
I'm a savage. Did you really go to Ulta if your hand don't look like this? Look at all these colors. Oh my God, look at this. Oh my God, Vanessa Jima is killing them. And then of course the liquid blushes. And I think I'm gonna get this palette. Oh, if you know like I know, okay? Juvia's Place is always pigmented. I love these liners, but realistically, I gotta stop buying stuff that I'm not really gonna wear. Like, when am I ever gonna wear a glitter liner? But oh, velvety matte, which I love, but the problem is it's going to smear everywhere. Good morning, good morning. So I'm actually in Chicago. I came up here for the weekend. I wanted to go to Kitchens and Cocktails by Kevin Kelley. So I wanted to do that before the end of the year. And there's also a Pink Wonderland exhibit downtown in Chicago. So I wanted to do that before I got so busy with the end of the year stuff. So, of course, it is raining down. And I'm about to go meet my homegirl Z for lunch and then, of course, going to dinner later. So, before we go downtown, I gotta go to Zara. There are some boots I've been wanting and some, well, a couple items actually that I want, but they're either online available or sold out. And they say that they're available, so I'm gonna go to two different Zaras to see if I can find it because they are bomb. So, let's go, honey. And I'm trying to stay warm because all of this here, clearly I should have checked the forecast before I left home. So let's go. So Zara is a bus. I wanted these, but they don't stretch. So I guess I gotta go down to Michigan Avenue, which I didn't want to do because the parking sucks. But it is what it is. It's my friend getting content for me. But they look so good.
Hi.
The Chris Brown. My girl Cassie.
I made it.
I've always wanted some penny loafers. Maybe I should get some. Let me see if they got them in my size. Okay. These are so cute.
Quit playing with her. Okay, I will literally put some pennies in these things. Quit playing with her. These are so freaking cute. I think I'm gonna get them.
When I tell y'all, my social battery is on 5%. I am struggling to hold on. So we are at a bar to grab some wings. The Pink Wonderland doesn't start until 11 o'clock. It is 7:40. I am peopled out. Like, I be at home. Like, I travel, but I be at home. I don't know how I'm gonna make it at 11, to 11. I'm gonna need a Xanax. Like, oh my God. My social battery. Y'all pray for me. But in any event, I got my boots. I'm so happy. I'm going to show them to you when I get to the hotel. I'm so happy. It was so worth coming down on Michigan Avenue, even though it was drama with parking. And, it was so worth it, though. Oh, my God. I'm so happy. Please pray for me. Good morning, good morning. And why is my thingy moving? Okay. good morning. I was so tired last night when we got back in from the Pink Wonderland. First and foremost, okay, if you are deciding, if you are trying to figure out if you want to go to the Pink Wonderland in Chicago, not unless you want to be at a whole pink club. Don't do it. I thought we were finna be roasting marshmallows. Okay, it was finna be like a do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do vibe. Ma'am, I thought I was at the techno club. You hear me? Baby, listen, I left my Meganese at home. Okay? I was like, where's the ho-ho-ho? Where is the Christmas festivity? Okay. Oh my God, it was not given what it was supposed to give. Okay, so got back, went to the hotel, got me some sleep. Okay, honey, I bought some self-care items that I was going to do for Sunday self-care. Baby, listen, I done jumped up. I need to go to Trader Joe's. It's 10 minutes from my hotel. Versus at home is 40 minutes away. I need to go to Dick's to see if they have my pink Stanley that I've been wanting, because I can't find it anywhere. It says sold out online, but maybe the Lord is with me and I'll find it. And I need to go to Target. I'm trying to do all that before it's time to check out the hotel.
So yeah, we finna see. But yeah, like I said, if you thinking you finna go to the pink ho ho ho, it's finna be. Mm-mm. Mm-mm. It's not giving. So let's go on Dick's real quick to see if they got this pink cup. Cross his fingers.
It's a look. What a cute idea. Limited time only sweet and salty. But they should have had regular Doritos. That would have been bomb. But that's a really cool idea.
What up, y'all? So I am back. Got back from Chicago a couple days ago, and I am getting dressed to go to Beyond Sweet. It's a new restaurant here. I'm going with a girlfriend of mine. So anyway, I wanted to show you what I picked up while I was in Chicago from Zara. Okay, I had to fix that. I wanted to show you what I picked up from Zara. Picked up from Ulta, and also just give you a quick review of the restaurant we went to. What was it called? Kitchens and Conversations with Kevin Kelley. Okay, so real quick, pros and cons, because I'm not that girl. I definitely love supporting Black-owned business, but I'm also tell the truth, so I don't want it to be, you know, like, oh my God, that's so bad. If it is what it is, right? So, con. I had to pay. Hold on, y'all. Hold on. Okay, I'll use this. I had to pay $13 for the reservation. I guess I'll use this. I had to pay $13 for the reservation, which it makes you say, down at the bottom, it tells you, it says like, please note that this $13 or whatever you pay for this reservation does not go towards your food, which I didn't like that because at other higher end restaurants, I don't care if it's a Ruth Chris or whatever that you consider to be a higher class restaurant, you don't have to pay for a reservation. So I thought that was kind of bogus, which don't get me wrong, I can understand because maybe in their mind, if you pay for it and you're willing to forfeit it, then at least they didn't, you know, lose. But I mean, $13, and then if depending on the time, it was $26, and that's per reservation, not per person. So okay, fine, whatever. And there's automatic gratuity. Okay, so that was the con. So I always stay in the suburbs when I go to Chicago. The hotel I went to, I put it down in the description. It was really nice. I think they said it had only been open like maybe a year. But it was really nice. Really, really nice. Was my given Roach Motel. Very, very nice. I forgot the name of it. So anyway, so we were running late to get to the restaurant. And it said it was 30 minutes away. But because of Chicago traffic, of course, you already know how that goes. It ended up being like an hour and 10 minutes. So even though, you know, we left in time, we were running late. So I called, like, hey, you know, trying to be like, hey, you know, it says on the website they give you 15 minutes. So I called. I'm like, oh, I'm trying to call. Honey, I don't know if it went to somebody's cell phone now, but it was like ringing four times and like going to a voicemail. Ringing four times and going to a voicemail, which I'm like, I don't understand. Like, what is going on? Okay. So to me, that's a con because I feel like at any restaurant, I should be able to call to speak to somebody about whatever. Okay. So definitely didn't like that. Get there, the restaurant Now, don't quote me on this. I think it's on Wabash. And I think it's on Wabash. Nonetheless, it's in the heart of Chicago, right? Heart of Chicago. So, parking is a mess. So, you get there. You got to find parking. We find meter parking. You know, it's the kind of parking where, you know, you got to put your driver, your plate number in and all that. Okay, fine. Get in there. Restaurant, gorgeous. Not going to lie. Gorgeous. And it's the kind of restaurant where, like, I could see having, like, a really dope event there. So, shout out to them because the restaurant was gorgeous. Definitely not going to hold you on that part. So I had already looked at the menu to see what I had wanted because, you know, ahead of time, I had already kind of knew what I wanted. So you can look at the videos, of course, prior to this to see what I got because I definitely don't remember, honey, at all. So it took about 30 to 45 minutes for us to get our food because they said they make everything fresh. And I wish they would have said that, like, ahead of time, like, when we were placing our order. Cause maybe I would have got like an appetizer or something. Cause you know, when you're going to a restaurant, you don't want to eat. So like I hadn't really ate that day. So a girl was hungry. Okay. So anyway, so we get our food. It was pretty good. Definitely not going to hold you on that. So definitely you're a pro. So pro, the restaurant was gorgeous. I could see somebody having a bomb event there. Like I said, they have a liquor wall. So when you walk in, I guess if you go there frequently, I don't know if you have to pay for it. Cause honey, I did not inquire. They have like a liquor wall and I saw like different names on there and then like their liquor. So like it was off like a little door, open up the door, like a little key and it's yours. So definitely thought that was the bomb. Thought that was really cute. Pro, the food was good. Definitely good. And this is the last thing, right? I got a lot of compliments on my outfit and what I had on, which I was like, oh, okay, I'll just, you know, put this little thing on, girl. Okay. So I got a lot of compliments on my outfit from the staff and the people that were there. So when we were about to get ready to leave out, it's this lady, she's like, she has like a camera. So I was trying to take a picture in front because like I said, as soon as you walk in, it's this beautiful like K&K by Kevin Kelley. And I think they had a tree. It was gorgeous. So I'm like, okay, I want to take a picture to her. So the lady like, hey, you want me to take your picture? She got a professional camera. Baby, she's taking pictures. I'm like, okay. Come back out. She's like, so another man come out like, hey, you know, she took your pictures. I'm like, okay, girl, come out with six photo frame, six. So I'm like, okay. I'm like, is they finna get, I know they're not finna give me these, but if they finna give me these, oh, girl, thank you. So look down, I'm like, oh, I love these. $25 per picture. 25. And yeah, I did buy one. So I guess they were like, cause I think the bill ended up being like, with the automatic gratuity, and I think we got like two dinners. I wanna say it was like 120. I mean, I don't know, it wasn't too bad, but I mean, like I said, I definitely would go again. It really was nice. But like I said, I just didn't, I didn't like the fact that you had to pay for your reservation, and I didn't like the fact that I couldn't call to speak with someone in regards to my reservation, whether it be to change it or whatever. So, okay, this is sticking. Cause I'm like, shoot, I could have been President Obama secretary to be like, hey, I was calling to, you know, say we want a reservation. So I don't know, but all in all, I definitely would go back again. It was good food, good customer service. Ambiance was gorgeous. Like I said, the restaurant is definitely gorgeous. It's just, you know how it is when you go to a big city and everything is busy and bustling and it's just like the parking and all of the people and all of the things. And my social battery, honey, because I have been out since like 9 a.m. I have been out like shopping and doing all. Honey, my social battery, as you can see, my social battery was down. So definitely go again. I would give it, I would say an 8 out of a 10. Only thing, like I said, is the two things. So if it's one in your area, I think he has one in Texas, one in DC, one in Chicago. I don't know, but it would definitely be worth you going if you like good food. I just hope they get somebody to answer the phone. So nonetheless, I'm gonna show you what I got from Ulta and Zara real quick so I can end the vlog, because I do not want it to be an hour. So hold on just a second, let me grab what I got from Ulta.
Zara.
Now let me get this quick disclaimer. I have never been a Zara girl, because prior to losing weight, Zara did not give what it was supposed to give to the fat girls, okay? So outside of me going in there for accessories, maybe shoes, I just never really shopped Zara, even though I've always wanted to shop Zara. So now that I'm like a large, extra large, XXL, I can fit some of their pieces. So I'm like, okay. So my girl, shout out to my girl here on YouTube. Her name is The Soft Nurse Brand. Stephanie, my girl, she posted a Zara haul, and honey, when I tell you, it stopped me in my tracks. Now I'm gonna show y'all these boots now, and I'm gonna need y'all to run and not walk to Zara if it's in your area, or go online. Now at the time that I'm posting this, these are still available online. These are still available online, so you gotta literally run to go get them, okay? And right now they're also having a sale. So, okay, now, pause for the cause, okay? I don't know. If y'all didn't gasp when this boot came across your screen, I don't really know what to tell you, but this is the boot that she posted, that Stephanie posted. I thought it was so cute. It's the silver tip. For me, okay, I'm a cowgirl through and through. Now, even though I am from Detroit, I live in St. Louis, honey, you cannot tell me that I was not born and raised on a ranch, okay? Because when it comes down to the cowboy boots, your girl is going to wear them, okay? Sign me up for all the colors, all of the things, okay? So also in my Target haul that I actually have coming up in a few days, I have some cowboy boots in that one as well. So I don't know. I don't know if that's the new thing for the season, but and the fact that I had to go downtown to get these, but they were so worth it. Oh my God, they were so worth it. And the lady, shout out to the young lady, girl, I ended up giving her a $20 tip. She went on the third floor of Zara and searched through and found these, and these were the last ones, so they were meant for me, which I'm just mad because now they're on sale and Zara does not do price adjustments, and I would have to drive 4 hours to get in a $40 adjustment. So it ain't that serious. So they were, I think, $100. I'll post it down. And it also says it has, $99.90. And these are a 41. So I always give my cowboy boots a 41, even though I wear between like a 9 and a 10, depending on the shoe. But baby, gorgeous. Okay, gorgeous. All right. So I got these because I am a silver girl. I thought these were really cute. I got some Nikes kind of like these, but I wanted these for like, you know, airport, ripping and running, whatever. Oh, not hitting myself in the face, y'all. Airport, ripping and running. I thought they were so cute. And I'm a silver girl, like I said. So, and these were in the 40. So a 10, and these were 49. All right. Now, hold on to your hats. These are the stunners. Okay. I had to find these. I was not leaving Chicago without it. I don't care if I had to go to all four Zaras in Chicago. Okay. Quit playing. When I tell y'all these were made for me, these were made for me, okay? Now, initially, I thought I couldn't get them on, but you kind of got to, like, finagle them up the leg. But, baby, when I tell you, I cannot wait to wear these. I'll probably be wearing them in my next vlog. I'm not sure. It is now snowing in St. Louis, 2 inches, which I'm not even trying to leave the house, and I'm so happy that I work from home. Thank you, God. I'm that girl. But if you tell me, if you do not comment and say these boots are not that girl, I can't really trust you, okay? Sis, ma'am, that girl. And look at the heel. The heel is not too much, honey, but they too much. And I love them, okay? And I want y'all to, look, I'm gonna have to leave word to be buried in these because it's that serious. Are these not good? Okay. They good. I don't care what y'all say. They good. So I'm wrapping up the vlog. I actually did get a silver moto jacket. It's just right. So I think I'm going to take the lining out of it. And I'll probably either post the details on it. I can't remember what I did with it. I got it in the mail and I was like, oh, I'm going to put this in my vlog. And now I can't remember what I did with it. So anyway, I am trying to wrap this up. I'm going to see y'all on the next vlog. I got to go. I know my homegirl is probably like, ma'am, come on. And thank you guys for watching. This is like actually fun. Like I'm gonna say this real quick before I end the vlog. I was running away from something that I actually enjoy, I think because of the fear of like the unknown, which we all do, right? But all of the signs are aligning. Like I have a job that allows me to shoot content. My work schedule is flexible. I now work from home. So like all of the things were aligning and I was like, you know what? Sky Daddy, you did that. Okay, Sky Daddy, you did that. So thank y'all for watching. Please comment and tell me what you think about the boots. If you go to the restaurant, Kevin Kelley's restaurant, let me know. Thank you guys so much for watching and I'll catch you in the next vlog.